working hours. You are very well aware that working hours are also restricted on the GO. Okay, so that you are all aware that by 6 o'clock, all shops and establishment, including even emergency medical shops, whatever, everything need to be closed. And actually, under you know, the curfew also commences from 7. So 6 means so that in 1 hour time they can go back to their homes. So that is the purpose. Okay, so pretty much the same. Ultimately, the impact on the employer is the same. Holiday is a holiday, whether it's a shop or establishment or a factory. So what does it mean? Holiday means it's a paid holiday. So normally, normal course, we notify national holidays, festival holidays every year. For factories, about 8 holidays we notify. For shops and establishment, we notify about 9 in the month of December every year. However, in case of emergency and special circumstances, government is empowered to issue any number of additional holidays. So accordingly, it has notified the holidays. So the impact is basically all the employees, though it's a holiday, so since it's notified as a holiday, they are entitled for full wages. What is wages? You know the definition of the wages. It's average wages. That's what it calls. So average, in respect of factories, during the last month, what is his average? Basing on that, you will allow the wages. And in respect of exemption category, I got like few people raised questions about how about because of lockdown, because no transportation, many employees are not able to attend the duties, right? So in such a cases, basically, you know, to the feedback which I'm receiving, even police and everybody are carrying the GO number 45 with them. If you show your ID card that you are working so-and-so industry, which is falls under the exempted category, they are allowing them to attend the duties. So as per the orders that are issued as on today, all exempted category employees are expected to attend the offices. Then only they will be eligible for wages. Whereas non-exempted category, invariably, they have to close down. Even if the employee, apparently, since you close down, employee won't come. But still, you need to pay the full wages. Not only up to the 31st March month, anyway, that's over. I'm assuming that many of you already paid the wages. Next 2 weeks also. That means if, up to 14th April also, they are entitled for full wages. So beyond 14th, now we cannot say unless the government takes a decision, policy decision, and going forward how it wants to implement the model. So at this point, I can only say till 14th, it's already notified as a paid holiday. Every factory need to pay, except those exempted category of establishments, shops and establishments, where since they are exempted category, unless the employee attends the duties, they are not entitled for wages. So this is my take on this whole holiday related issue. And shall I go through a few of the questions, or you want me to pause me for some time here? Mr. Shiva Sadagaru? I'm not able to hear Shivaprasad garu, but otherwise Ramachandra garu or Niranjan garu, one of you can probably, or otherwise any perhaps you can.
Niranjan garu?
Yes, sir.
I think you got some questions and then we can pass it on and then we can you can moderate it. So
yes,
it will become easy, right?
Yes, sir.
And question and answers, there are 5 questions already popping up.
Oh.
Should I read the question?
Yes, sir.
We have paid wages, salaries till 14th April 2020, from 1st April 2020, due to respect of GO 54 and 45. I think this Chandra Shekaram garu has already answered.
Yes, sir. This is already answered by the Joint Commissioner. So we have to pay wages till April 14th as per the directions given by the government of Telangana.
The next question which has been raised, can we know what are the guidelines issued by the central and state with respect to wages and payroll complaints like remittance of PF, ESI, PT and labor welfare fund?
Chandra Shekaran garu, can you answer, sir?
Basically, PFI is a professional tax. I cannot answer. Yeah. One of your experts can answer. About labor welfare fund, actually, you know that till 31st December, normally you'll be paying in the month of January. So yes, you are supposed to. We are in the month of April, okay? So, you're not paid, please pay it online. Now it's online provision is made. So that is fine. You will not have an issue. Okay.
So regarding ESI, already the ESI department have given extension for the February and March to be paid in the April and May. So 3 months extension ESI department has already given. Regarding PF, there is no extension so far. There is a possibility of giving extension within 2-3 days. That's what the unofficial news. But as on date, there is no extension to pay the PF contributions as on now. So ESI only, so far the extension is given.
So the next question is, contract workmen will be engaged from the pool for daily requirement, certain number from the pool on a rotational basis. If contractor has pool excess than the work order, shall we need to pay all or only as per the work order of daily supply?
See, basically, I can only technically speak. Basically, if he worked at least 30 days in the previous month, he is entitled for now leave wages during yes. this month. You know that, right? Under National Festival and Other Holidays Act, that's what it says. So they are entitled for wages, and my suggestion is and request also, please do pay the wages, okay? Because it's challenging times. And they are the lowest paid workers or worst sufferers normally during these times. It helps them in supporting their families. So continue to pay that. Otherwise also, previous month, at least 30 days, he worked, he will be entitled for his holiday wages.
Sir, Niranjan,
yes, sir.
There is a very interesting question on 25L.
Yeah.
Can an IT establishment with less than 100 workers lay off a 50% wage if no provision of layoff is there in the appointment order and standing orders? Would you like to answer?
Proceed, sir.
Okay, basically, layoff question doesn't arise for IT establishments within the provisions of Industrial Dispute Act. Basically, it's not an industry defined within the provisions of Industrial Dispute Act. Only 2M factories. Okay, are eligible, basically those layoff provisions, chapter 5B, what you call it, chapter 5B provisions.
Yes, sir. Chapter 5B, 25 excludes establishments. The 5B itself is not applicable to the establishments.
Basically, now till 14th, the question of layoff does not arise. After 14th, what comes, I cannot say right now, but I'm telling you from 22 to 14th, it's already notified as a paid holiday. Now, question of laying off them during this period does not arise. Then they need to be paid wages.
The next question is, ESI, we do not have option to upload areas. Yes, if the arrears cannot be uploaded, you have to add it to the current month and then make the payment. And the next question is, we are IT firm in Telangana. We asked our employees to work from home and they all acknowledged saying that they all amenities and work. Few employees came back saying they do not have internet and cannot work. Can we consider it as leaves?
No, that is actually, it's in the Jiva very fortified itself. IT sector is the exempted category and they are encouraged to all of the employees to work from home. Okay, an IT employee says he doesn't have internet. It's a surprising, right? So normally, you know, IT guys, they will have it, and anyway, they are not they're in the exempted category. Okay. They are under exempted category. They have to work and they don't pay the wages. Only thing is we wanted them to work from home as far as possible.
Whoever works, they will get entitled for salaries, in a sir. Whoever not attended to work, they are not entitled to salaries. Am I right, sir?
Yes, absolutely.
Labor welfare fund is not only about TS. I was checking in the other states. Too few states have labor welfare fund. You see, we will not be in a position to respond to questions pertaining to other states at this point in time, because that is a totally different situation. Therefore, Mr. Chandrasekaram Garu will not be in a position to answer this question on labor welfare fund, where Maharashtra and other places it is a quarterly payment. He will not be in a position to answer. I think it should be taken up separately.
But anyway, in our state, it's one-time payment, which is also a small amount. You know, just government per employee, which is very small. We don't have a monthly or quarterly system in state of Telangana. So, as far as our state concerned, it's one-time payment, normally payable after 31st December during the month of January. You are supposed to pay. It's an old issue. Already you would have been paid that. If you're not paid, please pay it immediately. And the amount is a very small amount. Okay, you know, it's a meager amount. Everybody knows that. Just 7 rupees per employee.
Yes. So next question is, will the paid holiday supply to the shops and commercial establishments too? Yes, Mr. Chandrasekaran Garu has already explained that it is applicable to all those establishments and shops which are not covered under the essential services and not under the lockdown. All the establishments which are under the lockdown, all the shops which are under the lockdown, these holidays are applicable to them. This has been very clearly explained by him. The next question is, my question on layoff was for establishments with less than 100 workers.
Now, the question of layoff does not arise. You see, one thing you need to understand that now the whatever the orders are issued, they are issued basing on the reference of the Disaster Management Act. It will have overruling effect under all that. Okay, it clearly gave a direction to notify the holidays for the lockdown period. Till the 14th, it's already lockdown, so none of the provisions will prevail. Now it's a paid holiday. Till that time, you need to pay the wages, because they are already notified holidays. During this period, layoff doesn't arise. In future, we will see what decision government takes. Depending on that, we will be able to comment on that.
Sir, on behalf of the other persons who have raised an issue on this, can I ask you a question, sir? How the Singareni collieries have declared layoff, sir, when this kind of situation? Singareni collieries declared layoff for undermines and other people employees. Whether they have taken any permission from government to declare layoff, sir?
Singareni, I am not aware. But to my understanding, normally it's not like 50% wages layoff. It's only paid layoff. Okay.
So total pay.
Total pay. Even see, somebody raised government can pay off the wages. Why not we? You know, even for us also, I'm clarifying it to you. It's not the off pay. It's only thing is paying it in installments, because enough money is not there in treasury. Probably in future, the rest of the balance will be paid to us. Okay. Don't treat that as if it's a one-time 50% settlement.
It's a deferred payment.
Yeah, yeah, that's the right word, deferred payment.
Yes, sir. Again, the same layoff issue, I think we will not debate it on further.
Yeah.
Questions?
Next question is, Chapter 5A applies to service sector as well, especially Section 25C, which takes up layoff. No, that is what, at this point in time, the layoff is not permitted. And subsequently, you can look at the provisions of the law. I think that is what Mr. Chandrasekaram Garu has clarified.
When it also the decision taken by the government. So ultimately, what kind of orders it's going to issue?
Yes.
The law they issue, basing on that, we'll be able to interpret that.
Yes. The next question is, when it comes to ESI payments, we added the wages and pay will, employee will have the benefit in the future. Their contribution will not be shown monthly. Will ESI entertain the claims for the set period? The question is not very clear.
If we add the wages and pay.
Have you understood what is the question?
No, sir. Ask him to send it again, sir.
Yeah, please send it again. Can we reduce the wages? Yes, we are an IT firm in Telangana. We had a couple of employees who were not performing and were informed to put under observation for a month, for a month now. As the evaluation is not positive, management wants to release employees with pay till 15th April. We asked the employees to resign and so we can proceed with release. Sir, non-performance is not a misconduct. We will not be in a position to ask them to leave without following the principles of natural justice, and then all the principles of natural justice are to be followed. And if somebody is doing a thing which is not in line with the principles of natural justice, which is not in line with the settled law, that is the management's decision and that is their view. Am I right, Niranjan?
Yes, sir.
Basically, suddenly, you know, I have seen many cases. No, yes, together you'll working, you'll find. Suddenly, one pride they will say is not performance is not good. And they wanted to terminate him. If that is done, at least you will have a right to challenge it. The unfortunate thing is they will ask them to resign, which they don't have right. Whether to resign or not, it's the prerogative of an employee. But anyway, if the question is about non-performance, my suggestion is just give them a reasonable opportunity, put them under PAP, performance improvement plan. Even after that, if he's not able to prove and reach up to your level, probably at least you will, you know, have some right to take an action. Straight away, prior to, you cannot decide the future of an employee by saying that his performance is good or bad. Okay.
Can we reduce wages with consent of union workers by executing an agreement? How do you see this arrangement, which is
any agreement which is not in accordance in terms of the law, in accordance with the provisions of the law, it's null and void.
Niranjan, would you like to add on this today?
And for time being, we can't do anything, sir. We can't reduce the wages. That is the GO 45 and this another GO by the government of Telangana. We can't reduce the wages, sir. We can't terminate and we can't reduce the wages. So any such agreement with the union, even though they agreed for the reduction of wages, but still it is not in accordance with the prevailing GOs.
You see, the next question is, what about wages payable to factory employees not attended duty pertaining to factory declared as essential services and running? This, both the GOs are not applicable, therefore they should attend to duties, and if they are not attending duties, they are not entitled to wages. This is what has been clarified by Mr. Chandra Shekaram Garu. Am I right, sir, Chandra Shekaram Garu?
Yes.
If you are giving public holiday for lockdown period, how these days will be calculated in leave calculation? I think there's a lot of time for us to discuss about leave calculation, which falls due in the month of December. See how things will develop.
After all authorized leaves normally will be considered for computing the...
No, sir. The difficulty is for factories under the Factories Act, for the computation 240 is counted. For the purpose of calculation of leave, it is not counted, sir. If to make him eligible, it is counted.
Yeah. That's right.
Uh-huh. But the leave period, it will not earn the leave again. That is the reason I think there's a lot of time to debate on this. I think we have enough time. We have to see what things are going to happen. Next question. If you are giving the same, can you please clarify, all establishments are liable for paid holiday or any exemption establishment is there. I think the same question is being repeated.
Yeah, we can avoid this question.
I think. Please also share a solution on how factories should run. We don't have deep pockets to keep paying. You see, for SMEs, a separate package has been announced for 1 crore loan without any security as a special case. SIDBI has a new policy has been declared. I think people have to find their own solutions.
You know, it's definitely a challenging time for everybody. Employees, employers, industry, government, it's like everybody are being impacted. So there is no sector, including workmen, all categories. So till 14th, this is the decision, policy matter decided already. Going forward in future, so, you know, I don't know, it's up to the government and trade bodies to represent and discuss and how they wanted to deal with the future situation. Ultimately, we can only talk about the decisions that are communicated to us.
So the next question is, if lockdown is extended, what is to be way forward retail organization? And is there any chance of giving subsidies to organizations? Kindly give some enlightenment in view. These matters, I think we will not be in a position to respond. Am I right, Chandrasekaran?
Yeah, at this moment, we will not be. But you, whatever concerns, a policy decisions, a government a support, you are expecting that you need to represent it to the government. So probably they will consider it when they are making decisions.
What about salaries to factory staff? Is salary cut allowed? No, the same thing is getting reported.
No. There is a fine line. See, whether under Shops and Establishment Act or this Festival and Other Holidays Act, the management cadre, basically, they should be covered within the definition of that employee, right? So,
yes.
Only all these paid holidays, other wages will be applied. So, employees in the staff, I cannot say, employees in the category of management. So, these orders won't apply.
Very great for your clarification, sir. That means the employer should understand the definition of employee under National and Festival Holidays Act, and also the definition of employee under Shops and Establishment Act, and then those employees for whom these holidays are applicable, for others it is not applicable. Am I clear, sir? Chandrasekaran Garu?
Yes, you are clear. And one more category, some people are talking about supervisory category. Supervisory category. You know, in ID, there is a limitation for supervisor category, but not under this National Festival Other Holidays Act. So, they are also eligible for this paid holidays, supervisory category employees. Okay.
So the next question is, we are giving construction machinery on hire to sites. Customers are saying they will not pay rent for the lockdown period. Is it legal? Niranjan, I request you to reflect on this.
We are giving construction machinery on hire to sites.
Sites. Customers are saying they will not pay rent for the lockdown period.
So that is a civil litigation, sir. If your customers are not paying their rent, then you have to claim it by filing a suit in a civil court. And now the major issue is a force majeure clause. Suppose in commercial contracts, if there is any force majeure clause, then that rent can be waived off. That depends on the terms of the contract with you and your customers. Suppose take for instance of PVR cinemas, IMAX cinemas, all these people are saying that they don't want to pay the rent for this period. On the ground, there was a clause in their agreement which deals with force majeure. So if that kind of clauses are there, then only it can be avoided. Otherwise, rent has to be paid.
Niranjan garu, I'll just add one word here. Yeah. A lot of them were told that you can wait for 3 months and later on pay the rent in installments. Is it true?
That depends on a person to person, sir. Everybody can take that, cannot take that stand. some organizations are not willing to give any waiver for any time also. So they are saying that rent has to be paid as per the contract. We are not concerned with the other issues. So only wherever there is a clauses in the agreement, that can be taken advantage of.
Probably in the same breath, Niranjan Gar, you can speak for 2 minutes and the legal aspect of it and the questions also you have with, you know, few of the questions you can share and discuss that. Probably next 2-3 minutes, then Ramachandran Gar will take over with a few questions.
Yeah, one more question we left Ramachandran Gar here. Sir, I have a question on gratuity payment. You missed that question.
Yes, many are screwing actually. Yes.
So you can take that.
Niranjan Gar, probably
question on gratuity payment. Our parent company in US and some of the associates has been directly employed by the US firm where they worked as an independent contractor. A separate legal entity has been opened in Tamil Nadu and they have been appointed as a full-time employee. They worked for 3 years in US and 3 years for Indian company. Are they eligible for gratuity? If the employee is employed by the Indian company and if he has worked completed 3 years service in US as an Indian employee working in US and 3 years in India, then he is entitled to payment of gratuity. Am I right, sir?
Yes, sir. Next, Raikumar, you have a chapter.
I want you to speak for 2-3 minutes, give a broad this thing about legal aspects, and then you also have few questions with you, no? Already you have taken. So you can speak for next 5 minutes, then probably later on Ramachandran Garu will add few more questions. And then Chandrasekharan Garu would have an unte chaptar tarvata, meer maatladin tarvata.
And these questions, can we go one by one?
Yeah, please go ahead. You have the questions, no? You read out and answer.
And Niranjan Garu, what is got repeated, let us avoid, sir.
Can we not take that questionnaires onto screen and evaraithe adigaro vallani teeskovalemma
teeskovachu you value and you just see what are the appropriate questions and pick them up and then if they are repeating just ignore them.
Yeah, so
go ahead.
There's a question. We are unable to pay salaries to the wages during lockdown beyond 31st March. What is the legal standing, Chandrasekharan Garu?
Can you repeat the question?
We are unable to pay salaries and wages during lockdown beyond 31st March. What is the legal standing?
I think legal already clarified to you. It has to be paid. Structurally, it's not paid holiday. For holiday, they are entitled for wages. Okay, so when you are notifying, once paying capacity is not considered. I know normal circumstances it will be different, but since it's a special situation, basically, you know, the purpose is the workman category. Normally they're lowest paid employees. Okay, so in any industry, workman category, they wanted to ensure that they are not suffering hunger or any other issues because they're lowest paid. That's why this I clarified to you, it doesn't apply to the management cadre. Only the workman cadre, which are defined under the law, and even supervisory cadre also entitled to that. You need to support them during these challenging times. Hopefully, beyond 14th, how the things will come out, we will see. Okay, till that time, they are eligible, they are entitled. You request to pay. You cannot say I don't have paying capacity.
Okay. Some questions we missed out.
We'll talk those questions later on, Andy. Just wait. Let Niranjan Garu has got few questions. He'll answer.
Yes. Right? Yes.
Yeah.
So, go ahead.
Yeah. To the many questions which was given to me, all are revolving around whether we have to pay salaries for the employees who are working in emergency services and who are not attending to the duty, despite of the providing of transport and other facilities. There are 5 or 6 questions on the same line. So my answer to this question is, if once the company is declared as an essential services, it is the duty of the employees to attend the duty. So therefore, whoever not attended to the duties, they are not entitled for any salaries. That issue will be different in case of non-exempted establishments, suppose shops, malls, and other places. they are not essential services, therefore they are entitled for paid holidays. In essential services, only the employees who attend to work will get the salaries. I think this is the, I got 7 questions on the same subject. Therefore, I think I am clear that all these issues will be closed, and Chandrasekaram Gar also confirmed this view that the only people who attended to work will get the salaries in essential services. Now the other questions mostly about the PF, in which the government of India recently has given some exemption for 3 months. Many people have asked about what is the procedure and what is the exemptions given. According to this notification, the employees below 100, and out of them 90% should be drawing below 15,000 per month, are only entitled to get the employer and employee share contribution amounting to 24% for the months of February, March, and April. Am I right, sir? April.
No. You see, the establishment which is registered under PF having code, the total manpower of that establishment should be less than 100.
Yeah.
The first condition. The second condition is out of that, in that entire establishment, the total strength 90% should be below 15,000 wage.
Yes.
When once these two conditions are fulfilled, then they are entitled for March, April, and May. 3 months provident fund contributions will be paid by the central government directly. Similar to that PMRPY scheme, wherein at the time of generating the challan itself, it deducts the amount and gives the final amount payable. Similarly, when this challan is generated itself, it should come as final payment payable. I am not too sure whether PF department at this point in time is really geared up to modify the website. I am not too sure, because you see, we have been trying to talk to them. They are telling people are not available, they are not coming, and the 150,000 applications have been received for the partial withdrawal of provident fund, which they are unable to process online. That is the kind of a situation. Therefore, we have to wait and see how this scheme will get implemented.
The other question many people have asked me is, what will be the legal implication for non-payment of wages or partial payment of wages during the lockdown period? Sir, there is a possibility of prosecution, and as per the Disaster Management Act, and there is also possibility the workers can file a claim for the difference of wages before the competent authority. So two eventualities may happen. You may land up in facing a prosecution and also payment of the balance of wages with penalty and interest. So a serious risk is involved if you don't pay the wages as per the directions of the government. Now the other issues which was mainly raised, other point was, whether we can terminate the employees as per the employment terms and conditions by giving notice period or payment lieu of. Maybe these software companies and other people are engaging many employees through an appointment letter. They're calling it itself as a contract.
Now, anyway, see, that is a, you know, very, I wanted to clarify. Basically, yes, terms of employment are not covered by the appointment letter. First, you need to understand that. Terms of employment are covered by the Industrial Employment Act, standing orders that are certified to establishment, or model standing orders that are already notified in the Act. And also, under the Shops and Establishment Act, there is a procedure also to terminate an employee under Section 47. So unless you follow that, whatever the action you take, it amounts to an illegal termination, for which an employee is at liberty to challenge it or approach the court of law.
Yeah. For this, I will add one more line, sir. See, the terms of your employment will not override the law, either Shops Act or ID Act or Standing Orders Act. Merely because you mentioned in your appointment letter so many clauses, that does not override the law. You have to follow the law, not the terms of your appointment, if they are in the workman cadre. you can only use this for the non-workman cadre who are managers, having some managerial powers. For them only the contract will apply. The workman cadre employees are governed by the Shops and Establishment Act or ID Act or Standing Orders Act. Therefore, by taking clue from the terms of the employment or appointment letter, you can't terminate now. Am I right, sir?
Yes.
Yeah. That's right.
So the next other point is VOCW benefits and its administration for constructing manpower under COVID. So I think the finance minister has already instructed that the amounts which are lying with the VOCW fund can be used for the benefit of these workers.
What the benefit?
So VOCW, some funds are there, sir, Building and Other Construction Workers Act.
Can you repeat that question? I somehow lost it.
What are the benefits under the VOCW Act and its administration for the workers under the COVID?
Okay, basically, I just wanted to clarify to you. Normally in VOC establishments, most of them will be migrant workers only, which normally comes from Orissa, Madhya Pradesh, even Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh. Okay. So we already conducted a quick survey establishment wise. First them from the funds of VOCW. The process already started. It's ongoing. It takes a little more time. Basically, each migrant worker, the government is providing as a one-time relief under COVID situation. 12 kg rice per each worker and 500 rupees to each worker. So one is cash component, other one is a rice component. So these are being provided across the state. It's already started. JHM's area also just started. Probably next two to three days time, we are trying to cover everybody. Actually, we identified through our quick survey close to 3.35 lakhs migrant workers who are currently employed in the state of Telangana. For them, we are paying. Even if somebody are not covered also, normally they can contact the concerned our assistant commissioner, deputy commissioner, or even message me also. We will in turn will ensure that the benefit is extended to them. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So again, Mr. Jaipal Reddy is putting the same question. What about essential services employees if they don't attend? I think it is clarified clearly, very clearly, that they are not entitled for wages if they don't attend to work where the lockdown is not applicable.
So next,
continue.
Next question is, sir, whether we can defer or postpone the EPFO payments for another 2-3 months. So right now there is no kind of any possibility from the government authorities, and there is a possibility for extension. But if such extension is given also, they may charge you interest and damage for the delayed payment. So kindly keep it in view. Merely granting time does not mean that is being given at free of cost. Interest and damage will follow if the time is extended for further period. So that should be considered before whether we have to avail this benefit or not. Next question is, can we defer the bonus in these circumstances? Bonus, I think you have a time up to November. March is the year ending and you have 8 months time to conclude that. Before November, things may change and so many things may happen. So at that point of time, we can see what is to be done with regard to bonus.
Sir Niranjan, I would like to add.
Yeah.
The bonus is based on the financial year 19-20. This situation has arisen only at the fag end.
Yeah.
The bonus becomes payable based on the balance sheet of the financial year 19-20, and it is a statute requirement. If he is covered under the Payment of Bonus Act, they must pay the bonus.
Oh, sir, for that also we have time up to November, eh, na?
Yes.
That is the
some people pay in the month of April, May itself. That is the reason.
Yeah, anyway, you got still a long way to go, a lot of time to worry about the bonus.
Correct.
Talk about the month of November. Okay.
So another question is, as it is a yearly appraisal period, all the process has been completed except management decision on finalization of the data. Can they announce that there would be no appraisal for this year? Yes, it can be done.
Appraisal, actually, it's not a statutory thing that you do it. Okay, it's up to the management. So to give increment or not to give increment, it's prerogative of the management.
Yes, sir. So the appraisal can be postponed if they so want.
Yeah, it's up to the
So next question is, if the government has declared as a company as essential services, but the company workers did not turn up for work, we need to pay them or not? Same thing about the same issue of essential services not attending. And the other issue is, sir, how to calculate wages for piece rate contract workmen? For example, in cement, we will pay the cement per ton, cement dispatch. Since this month only 21 days dispatched, remaining 10 days, how the contractor should pay?
The average of the preceding 3 months earnings is an yardstick subject to payment of minimum wage.
Basically, last 3 months, at least 30 days continuous period, average wage into that need to be taken. You understood, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that is 30 days average period, covering 3 months period. Okay.
Sir, next question is, sir, as per the government of India or state government, treat these holidays as paid holidays and instructed employees to pay the wages during this period. Is there any chance to withdraw the remaining paid holidays till year end? Can they take that decision? What decision government will take?
Notified holidays will remain. These are only additional holidays to take care of a special situation.
Yes. What are the measures that an organization we can take to support our employees, as most of the organizations are having financial issues and few are not even able to pay employees, especially the startups? How would you manage the situation if you are an HR of an organization and company wants to your intervention to manage financial crisis and the front end of their situation, so that every company has to organize their finances and pay their amounts and other things? What the joint commissioner or somebody can advise how your financials should be maintained? Sir, that depends on the company and your internal sources you have to manage, how best you have to come out of the situation. So this is not the forum on financial matters to advise you, sir. Am I right, sir?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Agreed.
Yeah. So in case the lockdown is further extended, do the companies liable for payment of wages to staff
on
casual leaves, or at the discretion of the management? In case companies are liable for payment, if such establishment is running in losses, what is the legal remedy does the companies can exercise? Suppose the lockdown is extended.
Yeah, at this moment we cannot say if it extended, what would be the scenario and what kind of whether it's a paid holiday or some other alternative. Ultimately, see, I'm sure government will also make appropriate decision in consultation with the industry. You are also at liberty to represent the government. Going forward, we cannot say at this moment how it's going to, what kind of orders, instructions or policy decisions will be taken. Fingers crossed. So that anyway, once it comes, I will be in a position to explain.
Sir, we are being the manufacturer of edible oils and permitted to operate. Are we liable to pay wages to workmen who absented during the lockdown period?
It's already clarified many times. Yes. So normally in GO 45, there is a list of establishments. So you know that banks, ATMs, print and electronics media, IT and ITS establishment, telecom, postal, internet services, supply chain, transport and essential commodities, e-commerce, and food items, based sale of food items, groceries, hospitals, okay, diagnostic centers, petrol pumps, LPG, all security services, and there are separate one more list of industries. So these are all, they are expected to come, and I already told you.
Sir, manufacturing of edible oils is an essential service, sir?
Yes.
Yeah, I think it's...
Food and food grades.
Food grade items, right? It comes under that. Yeah.
Okay.
Next question.
One. the diploma internants are eligible for payment of stipend during the lockdown period. Internship, like apprentices or trainees, whether they are entitled for stipend during the lockdown period.
Frankly, I don't know. That's covered under Apprentice Act. If they are employed under Apprentice Act and paid apprenticeship wages, that is a different. But if they are, you know, director, some kind of trainees without reference to Apprentice Act, you need to continue to pay the wages.
Yes, sir. As a retail organization, how to go about if lockdown is extended and any subsidiaries for organization? Lockdown extended means what happens, we don't know. So we can't say what will happen if we lockdown is extended.
Yeah, we can clarify it on 50th probably.
So that's all main questions, sir, for me.
All the questions are same. There are no additional questions. I think we've covered all the questions what they have raised.
Yeah, mostly covered.
Everything is covered, sir. You see, there's a new question has come up. Please suggest a website for us to check the updates on all our labor laws relevant to shops and establishment. Sir, my earlier question has been missed out. As per the new amendment, EPF could be withdrawn, PF could be withdrawn 75% on 3 months basic pay, whichever is lower. My question is whether it is taxable. In case if we withdraw the 75%, when we are allowed to do the next partial thing, what happens? Now, any payment received, if it is not locked in for a period of 5 years, then that payment will become taxable. Whatever amount received will become taxable. If you are a member of the Provident Fund, if the accumulations are more than 5 years old, if you withdraw that money is not falling under tax. Anyway, now the tax laws are going to change this financial year. The options are given. Therefore, what kind of a view it will be taken, we are not too sure. It directly pertains to tax laws. Many IT companies are forcing employees to take unpaid leave. Is it correct?
See, it's not correct. Definitely it's not correct.
Can I just come in now, instead of now speaking up all the questions again and again, because most of them are repeating and some of them have just joined and they're typing the questions. I suggest probably Chandrasekharan Gar, you just take another 1 minute or 2 minutes and conclude from your side what advice you would like to give and what are the rules and things. Similarly, Niranjan Garu will do, then Ramachandran Gar also will do. So over to you, Chandrasekharan.
Basically, whatever the orders comes, we'll try to post on our website, Labor Department website. You know that labor.telangana.gov.in. We try to keep it updated with all the GOs and orders. Okay, that is one thing. And again, just now I received, if migrant workers have not received any ration, whom do we need to follow up? You can just message me or you can message to our Deputy Commissioner of Labor, Mr. Pramod Reddy, if you got his number, in respect of Rangareddy district. In other districts that are concerned with DCL, you can communicate with them. In turn, we normally follow it up with the district administration. Through, you know, civil supplies department, they are paying all this rice, and the money for this rice and rupees 500 per worker, we are paying from the funds of the construction workers welfare board. Okay, so I think with this, broadly the question is about whether to pay or not to pay wages. That has been raised. It's very clearly mentioned. It's already notified within the provisions of the law that need to be implemented. Okay, going forward, the situation at this moment will not be in a position to say anything. Definitely, your concerns, I am sure there are forums, even the, like this FAPC also there are CAAs are there. Ultimately, you know, it's definitely your opinions, your issues also will be concerned before a decision is taken at government level. But once it comes, the implementation aspects, issues, clarifications, we are always ready to provide that. Okay. Thank you. If you got still any questions, you can always contact me or message me. I will clarify to you. Okay? Thank you.
Over to Niranjan Garu. Probably you can add a few concluding remarks.
Yeah. Still we have 15 minutes time, sir.
Yeah, but still we will come back. Yeah.
So now, my friends, many of the issues is that suppose what happens if you don't pay the wages, or if we terminate the employees, or if we declare layoff, or if we force the employees to go on leave. That kind of issues are looked at because of the prevailing situation. We can understand the problems of the management. But at the same time, if you go on taking this kind of activities, we may face the prosecution as per the Disaster Management Act, and then there will be a possibility of imposing penalties on the management for violating the orders of the government. So it is not advisable now to stop the payments, even though we have some financial difficulties. So better we honor the order of the government right now, and we will see how best we have to come out of the situation once the lockdown is extended, or maybe the government may consider the problems of the industry and they may come out with some kind of reliefs. We will wait and watch. But till April 14th, it is better you pay the wages for all the employees who are governed by these notifications. And the second issue is that the declaring of layoff was been on the cards, as I now spoken to Chandrasekharan Garu. Singareni colonies have declared layoff, even though they are having more than 100 workers. So once the above 100 workers industry is there, it is mandatory for them to take a permission from the government before declaring a layoff. How that organization has taken that kind of a stand, we are unable to trace the reasons, whether the government has given such permission or without any permission they declared layoff. That is one issue which we have to examine, and then if that is permissible, then we can probably think of declaring layoff by paying 50% of the salaries for the coming period, if that works out. So therefore, better in these prevailing circumstances, it is better to comply the law and follow the orders of the government. And once the April 14th is over, we will decide what will be the next course of action. That is all from my side, sir.
Ramachandran Garu?
Sir, I think we have addressed all the concerns, but the real issue here is the situation is more socio-economical, emotional issue at this point in time. Even when the lockdown is also lifted, the industry will not be in a position to come back to its normalcy as expected by most of us. It will take at least another 2 to 3 months for the industry to come back to the normalcy. Therefore, the pressure on the organizations does not end with the lifting of the lockdown and payment of wages of lockdown period. After this period, I think we have to become more proactive in dealing with the issues, keeping in with the financial constraints of the companies. How do we find solutions with a mutual consent with our people? Because the manpower shortage also will become very high in the state of Telangana. All the migrant workers who are there now in Hyderabad and Telangana, they prefer to run away to their places the moment the lockdown is lifted, because they have a social responsibility, psychological connect with their families. And those who left already, they would not like to come back immediately, unless otherwise the things are settled fully. Therefore, there's a lot of shortage of manpower will take place on its own. And all the organizations and HR function should take a proactive role after the lockdown period. In fact, that is more crucial period than today. Now, today the only issue is we are discussing about payment of wages. But the bigger issues will emerge soon after the lockdown is lifted. Hence, my request is that we have to find proactively how do we manage ourselves after reopening of the organizations, right? Now, I think anybody have any question, they can mail to me. I think I will discuss with Mr. Niranjan and Chandrasekharam Garu, and we will respond to you. I think that's all I have to say, Ravikumar Garu.
Okay. Yeah. Before I close, probably I request my president to say a few words, then I can give the vote of thanks.
Yeah.
Karnendra Garu, please.
Yeah, thank you, Ravikumar Garu. And it's been a good hearing from the renowned people in this particular trade, and of course, the officers from the department. But however, there are a few things that have been popping up, as you rightly said, who have joined in late. They're still coming in the chats. And we will definitely keep track of those chats and, you know, try to reply to them after getting your individual assertions. However, for somebody, some of them who have missed this, we are trying to put this recording on our website so that it will be of benefit if you can go back and listen to all the deliberations. And of course, there are some slight hitches as a startup thing, and which we will resolve and prepare some standard operating procedures to make this more inclusive. Thank you very much for all of you, sir, for being here with us this evening. And I hand over now to Mr. Ravikumar to propose his vote of thanks.
At the outset, I think I am really grateful to the Telangana government, and we are very grateful that Chandrasekaram Garu, Joint Commissioner Labour, has agreed to be with us and then give us. In fact, from FTCCI, I would like to say that we are very happy with the performance, the way Telangana government is taking charge and then helping everybody. And we once again thank you, sir, Chandrasekaram Garu, and we will always keep disturbing you. Whenever we have, I think we have the liberty to disturb you and take your advice whenever we require. And I also thank my co-panelists who have been with FTCCI, Ramachandran Garu and Niranjan Rao Garu, who are also part of our committee, HR and IR committee. And before I sign off, I once again repeat that any question answers which the participants who are there on the web right now would like to get more clarifications, kindly send it to FTCCI or our web and we'll definitely answer. Thank you once again. Have a nice layoff and utilize it constructively. And we have no choice. We have to work hard and then move ahead in life. We have to look way forward and then run the show, the business. Thank you. I think all doubts have been cleared. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Sandy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.